Before I get into my main topic, Madam President, I just wanted to briefly respond to something that the senator from New York, or Democrat leader, said regarding the tax cuts bill that passed in 2017. The Democrats, who none of whom voted for it, obviously, have not ceased criticizing the passage of that tax relief bill, notwithstanding the significant economic progress that we've seen as a result of its passage, coupled with relief from regulations and other policies that have been implemented by this president working with the Congress, to the point where you have historic economic data to report. I mean, we have record unemployment rates all across the country, and we've seen record wage increases. Senator from New York talked about how this hasn't benefited working Americans. That couldn't be further from the truth. If you look at the data, it's very clear that wage rates are growing, and they're growing at the fastest rate in over a decade. You've got actually more jobs available today in this country than you do people looking for jobs. Also a historic first, and something that's been now happening for many months in a row. So record low unemployment, record high wages, and growth in the economy that we haven't seen in over a decade either. 3.1% in calendar year, fourth quarter over fourth quarter, is the first time we've seen 3%, north of 3% growth in our economy since 2005. So it's pretty clear, if you look at the evidence, that the tax relief bill that was passed by the Congress and signed into law by the President in late 2017 is having the desired effect. And with respect to the arguments that were made about this is going to, this is what's contributing to the debt and the deficit, there was a piece in the Wall Street Journal by a former colleague of ours, Senator Phil Graham from Texas here, just this last week, which pointed out that the Congressional Budget Office has adjusted its projections when it comes to growth in the economy since the tax bill passed. In 2017, when it was in the process of being passed, the CBO was projecting 2% growth in 2018, 1.7% growth in 2019. They have now modified those projections to 2.9% in 2018 and 2.7% in 2019. And what that means is additional percentage point of growth means higher government revenues. And in fact, the CBO has adjusted their projections with respect to government revenues upward by about $1.2 trillion over the next decade. $1.2 trillion would be about 80% of what the tax bill, projected cost of the tax bill was, about $1.5 trillion. And we predicted at the time that we would see additional economic growth as a result of passage of tax reform and allowing individuals and businesses, whether they're organized as C-Corps or whether they're organized as pass-throughs, to benefit from these provisions and changes in the tax code, faster cost recovery, lower rates, that would encourage them to invest and grow and expand their operations. That's exactly what's happened. And as a result of that, you've seen government revenues, according to CBO, based on their projections, going up and up by over $1 trillion. And again, that almost 80% of pays for the cost of the tax bill that the Democrats are so quick to criticize as contributing to the deficit and the debt. So, Madam President, I would argue that if you look at the facts, facts are stubborn things. If you look at the record, if you look at the data, if you look at the statistics, all point to the impact that tax reform and other pro-growth policies that have been implemented by the Trump administration and this Republican Congress are having the desired effect. We are seeing increases in wages. We are seeing, obviously, a tremendous impact on growth and on jobs in this economy. And that's good for American workers. Obviously, when you reduce tax rates, that hopefully benefits everybody. But when you have a growing, vibrant, robust economy, that lifts all the boats. Everybody benefits from that. And we're seeing the effect of that as a result of those policies. So I know the Democrats all voted against it, so they have every reason, I suppose, to try and criticize it. But if you look again at the facts, if you look at the record, if you look at the actual data, you get a very different conclusion from the one that they're trying to put forward in advance.